thank you very much for tuning in to our YouTube channel today. You're watching the New England Roller Derby Report special presentation from the Midcoast Recreation Center in Rockport, Maine. It's kind of a big deal that we're broadcasting from here today because traditionally this has been one of our harder venues to try to do anything from.
It is.
Less than a month from today, actually are supposed to broadcast an entire tournament that will go over the Coastal Chaos Tournament. That's going to be over a 2 or 3 day period, which we said, yeah, we'll definitely do that, knowing full well we actually did not have the technical capability to do so. Necessity is the mother of invention, and I have the mother of all antennas outside this building hooked to the back of our Durango. I have some pictures. I'll post them later. It's really incredible.
Essentially, we're in a bunker.
Yeah, we're in a bunker here. This place is it's intense.
I mean, it's an ice rink, but it's walled in like a bunker.
So hopefully today's broadcast goes off pretty smooth. We've already seen there's a few things that kind of limit our frame rate and our upload ability just a little bit. I'm not 100% sure where the bottleneck might be for that, but we'll try to figure it out, and hopefully everything here will normalize a little bit. We'll find out shortly. We're going to try a couple of different things today. You'll notice we're using a picture-in-picture of the bench area, so we'll see how that goes. I already feel like I'm not sure I like it because it's so distracting.
It is kind of distracting.
It's like they skate through and then turn. It's just weird. So I don't know. We might just ditch that. It's all about it.
We'll see. We'll play with it.
We experiment 100% of the time, all the time. introductions. I'm Chad.
I'm Ginny.
It's just the two of us today.
It is. Again, the two of us.
Yeah, until we find a Jeff 2.
Yeah.
Jeff sequel.
Yep.
Jeff 2 Electric Boogaloo.
2.0.
Jeff 2.0. Today we have a pretty fun matchup. New Hampshire Roller Derby.
We do.
Coming up, they're crossing the border here into Maine. Maine and New Hampshire. Interestingly enough, New Hampshire is the only state that Maine borders.
Yes.
So it's an important border.
Yes.
We protect it with our derby, and we're going to, you know, everyone talks about militias, but we actually have derby teams, and Maine and New Hampshire work together quite frequently. I feel like our stream is actually kind of normalizing, but it kind of goes in and out, and I think we'll drop frames as a result of that, but whatever.
Yeah.
I don't know.
And I don't have access to our chat on YouTube either,
because
I have no internet access in the building on my phone,
so we'll have
which is
no
where I
idea
normally read it. So
if
that's okay,
if it's crappy or not, we won't know until after people will
even
let us know.
Even if they text us,
yeah, we can't even get
I can't
a text
even
in
get
here.
A text in here, so
not knowing exactly when we're going to start and get underway here today, let's go ahead and take a look real quick at our stats for this week. I like to play happy fun time with the rankings, courtesy of Flat Track Stats. I make this ranking.
Right.
I make it with Flat Track Stats numbers.
Right.
But
this is Chad's standings.
This is the standings here in Maine, according to the ranks. Not a whole lot of change over the last week, but some kind of cool stuff happened. Maine Roller Derby picked up a win 2 weeks ago against Providence. Not Providence. Rochester.
Rochester.
Yeah, Rochester,
Rock City.
Rock City came up. A game we almost broadcast, but not quite.
We were so close.
So close. It almost happened.
And then we lost it.
Yeah, we lost it. So they picked up another 4.8 points in their rating, so they've increased their lead. And Aroostook Roller Derby had a game against the Mad Hitters across the border in Canada. They came away with a win. So they've gone up 5.9 points, which puts them past Bangor Roller Derby's B team into seventh place.
Wow.
Today we'll see if anything changes. I don't know if we'll see a change from today. So even if Rock Coast comes away with a win today, they probably will only see an increase of somewhere in the neighborhood of 5 to 6 points, which they won't quite catch up to Bangor Roller Derby with that one, but they can certainly
It'll get him close. A little bit. But Bangor has a game next weekend.
That's true. So one of the other things, too, I think that can impact that is if Rock Coast were to come out and really annihilate, that could potentially happen as well. So,
right.
So that's what's kind of going on there with stats here in Maine.
So I have in my hand.
What do we have?
Not what I thought I had.
Oh, womp, womp, womp.
Oh, that's too bad. Oh, there they are. Rock Coast Rollers would like to thank their amazing Zebra crew. Testosterone Jeremy, Wife O, Mr. Fantasy, Colin Offenses, Flash Drive, Noah Apologies, Molotov Latte, Camel Topher, Coptimus Prime, Irma Gerd, Firecracker, Truck Norris, Ducky, Graceless Kelly, Glitterella, Biova, Temple of Doom, McMasher is also here.
McMasher. Saw McMasher.
Yeah,
she's
sitting right over here next to us.
Yeah, she's
she came in.
She's got the non-skating official duties today.
Yeah. Yep.
And today also the triumphant return of the Zebra watering hole.
Yeah, that's a big deal because
it's a big deal because that would
we broke it a couple of weeks ago.
Yeah, a couple of games ago. It took a ride around the back of the vehicle
for way too long and it just didn't hold up.
And it broke.
So you fixed it this morning.
I did.
And that's pretty exciting.
Yeah. So we had some happy looking officials. And then some not so happy officials because it was broke the last time they were on skates. And today they.
Yeah, that was Tugboat. He's actually Tape Ninja. You can see him over there.
There he is out there. Yeah. Look at him.
He's got Tape Ninja skills.
He hasn't even started the game yet. He's all over
that. I know.
That.
He is. He's doing great.
So these two teams met the last time they met. Last spring, it was actually pretty close to this time of year, and it might have been a little earlier in the year, and Rock Coast came away with the win in that case. I think it was pretty close, though. I could go to flattrackstats.com, and I could probably find that. But they did manage to come away with a win, and they have added some to the roster since then.
Mm-hmm.
New Hampshire's roster looks pretty similar to what we saw last year. I see. It looks like there may be a few names that have come up from the Cherry Bombs to the A team here for the All Stars. I do think one player that we're not going to see today for New Hampshire is Janelle Ellison. So I don't think Ellison made the trip up.
We haven't seen her yet.
Haven't seen him, but that's fine. I think New Hampshire will probably be okay. They would always be better though with Janelle, because Janelle's pretty damn good. Perfect Storm, quite a few changes here. In the offseason, Storm have added Grim Demise, Kissy Kicks, Princess Layer out, and another name coming back that we didn't see for the second half of last year, Scarina is back. Mm-hmm. Scarina took some time off to recuperate, and she'll be back in action tonight.
She's always fun to watch.
Yeah, a ton of fun to watch. And we will be able to watch. As long as the network connection holds out.
Yeah, as long as that little box is still green.
Yeah, as long as that. And immediately it's, yeah, you red. Said that. And it's going to drop and then it's going to go away.
I'm just not going to talk because that seems to change it.
Yeah, I don't know why it varies the way it does. Unless it's windy. And if the breeze is blowing it around.
That's true. That's a good point.
So if the breeze dies down, that may change our giant mast situation. So we'll see.
Mast.
If the archived copy of this game is garbage.
Lesson learned.
And I will remove it.
A couple of weeks to tweak.
I'll remove it and I'll add the recorded copy.
The important thing to take from this, though, is that we're always trying to improve.
Yeah, always trying to do something different. Like,
right.
Yeah.
To make it better, to reach farther, to do more.
Bigger,
every location,
stronger,
yeah,
faster.
Every location is different, so we have to do different things at different locations. So we're trying.
So, yeah, I don't
Bear
know.
Bear with us. And we have a pretty exciting halftime.
We do, if it works.
If it works.
Yeah, we're going to what we're going to do during halftime today is actually going to cut over to Mixler, where we have a couple of tournaments going on. We'll probably tune in. We'll try first the Siege of New York tournament, see what we can find going on down there, and we'll let that roll through halftime. Because I didn't put together anything else for halftime, so.
Yeah.
Why not let somebody else do the work for me?
Our old friend Mixler.
Our old pal Mixler. We're so excited to find out. I woke up this morning and said, oh, look, this is on Mixler. And then, so Siege of New York.
Mm-hmm. It's a round robin.
Yeah, it's a little
style.
Little tournament.
Yeah.
And then also another round robin tournament being put on by
DC Roller Girls.
DC Roller Girls. And I was able to listen to our friend Kent the Politician on the way down today.
Yep.
He was broadcasting, and I think it was, I don't remember. I don't remember what the teams were. I only listened in just so I could listen to Kent.
Yeah.
Yep. So I think we're going to get underway here pretty soon.
Yeah, do you want to do intros, teams?
We can, but we'll wait till they take the track first.
Oh, you want to do it while they're up there.
Yeah, gotcha. Yeah, because it looks a lot cooler.
All right.
So isn't this strange? I mean, I need somebody who's really smart to tell me why this happens. Like, we've got a really solid connection, and then it just dies.
So, a big thank you to the skating and non-skating officials. I already read off our skating officials.
Yeah, you did.
And non-skating officials.
While I was
officials.
Working on some
also,
technical things.
Also, a thank you to our wonderful EMTs for keeping everybody safe. We appreciate them. We couldn't do this without them. This is a big thing right here is we wouldn't be what you see today.
We wouldn't be
without the generosity of these spectacular
people.
Oh,
man. Yeah, let's talk about these people.
These people have been very generous. Most all of the things that we have here that we broadcast with is because of these people.
Yeah, we got ourselves to a point last year at the end of the season where we got video going, really kind of rudimentary. Well, this is pretty rudimentary now, but we got rudimentary video going, and we wanted to be able to increase it to a, you know, something more stable, something visually more appealing. We found some things along the way that weren't working great with audio. Mm-hmm. Me, I haven't fixed anything for that yet.
Jeff laughed.
Jeff, yeah, Jeff is
sorry.
Gone.
So the following people have donated to our GoFundMe, which we greatly appreciate. Because, like we said, we wouldn't be able to do it without them. And it's with their help that this has been able to happen. And
people like you.
Yeah, they've helped us bring Derby to the masses. Bella LeBral, Malice Borealis, Firefly, Head of Flame, Tugboat and Grim, Nancy Hoffman, Julie Knowlton, Desiree McHugh. Anonymous.
Oh, thank you, Anonymous. You know who you are.
Christine Simoneau, Dennis and Melody Bergeron, Oso Loco, Otter Mayhem, Randy Hunt, Pyromaniant, Anonymous.
Another Anonymous. This
we
is
love
different.
Anonymous.
They know the differences, too.
And Fuzzy Logic.
Fuzzy.
All of those people have donated to our GoFundMe.
And, yeah, you know, we've been able to do things like...
Get the cameras.
Even if it's not perfect right now, the antenna situation.
Yep.
That is a result of folks helping out on the GoFundMe. We would not have been able to do that without them. The audio changes that we needed to make, you know, we're halfway through that. This headset microphone. Holy
it's
crap.
Pretty
it
awesome.
Makes such a difference.
You get to stand up.
I can stand up. It makes it a lot easier for us to do all of our broadcasting, you know, when we
it's
have
pretty awesome.
Less equipment that we have to mess around with.
And like I said, we wouldn't be able to do that without you.
Yeah, everybody
wonderful
who helped
help.
Out was pretty phenomenal. So thank you
we
very much.
We appreciate that.
All
right.
I'm
let's
still
see.
Trying to figure out why we're losing about 70% of our.
Between here and there.
The system that we have right now, if you care about these kind of things, outside of the building, I have a mast antenna that is mounted to the back of our vehicle. It's probably, I don't know, about 15 feet tall. And on top of it is a special LTE antenna. It works with the same frequency as 4G would. Runs through a giant 60-foot cable into the building, where it goes to a laptop acting as a server for us. And then that laptop is sharing its internet access with us. And then we are across the rink and can see it from here just about. So somewhere along the line there, something's not working as perfect as it should, but that's okay.
We've lost the line of sight or something.
Yeah. I actually think it might be the breeze blowing the antenna around.
Right.
We're going to probably have the national anthem here fairly soon. I don't know if they're singing it or if they're actually playing it.
I think they're playing it.
All right, so we're going to just kind of mute that so it doesn't, YouTube doesn't get angry with us.
Oh, I did have the in screen open on that one.
I actually turned it on midway through.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Okay, I was going to say, yeah. I turned around and put my hand over my heart, and I'm like, oh, shoot, I should have put that in.
Yeah, we, it may sound a little weird. Why would we mute the national anthem? That's because it's a copyrighted recording of the national anthem.
It is.
And YouTube gets cranky about that. So, that's why. I can sing it for you later or now if you'd like. Or not. You did not immediately seem enthusiastic about that. I got to figure out what's going on with that connection.
So it looks like New Hampshire is taking the center of the track for their introductions, I'm guessing?
Yeah, introductions going to happen soon.
We want to bring those up and get those started?
Oh, yeah, we should probably do that. In a moment.
Thank you.
So our New Hampshire All-Star team, as we've been tinkering here on our connection.
Sorry, I was tinkering.
That was the silence.
It's just crazy. I don't understand why it doesn't stay solid. I'm wondering actually if it will get better as the sun goes down and the breeze stops.
It's all technical stuff we'll I don't really understand.
I'll have to turn the sun off next weekend when we're here. It's fine. I don't mind going that far to get this to make
put
this
that
happen.
Request in. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. We can do that. So your all-stars for New Hampshire. Oh, they have a little something going on.
Oh, they got an intro.
Yeah. I wondered them all huddled up. What was?
Yeah. What was
that
going
was part
on
of
there?
Their intro. So, are you reading these?
Sure. Breaking away from the inner circle first is Kamikaze Kink. I won't be reading these in the same order as our in-house announcer.
No,
I better not do that. It was just only happened to be the first one. Kamikaze Kink, Amanda Goodell, Knockahoe Down, number 4, Emily Deckerson, number 10, Irate Pirate, number 17, Angelina Joe Lethal, 22, Jinx, 85, Punky, 91, Bo Loco, 203, Vendetta, 626, Janelle Ellison. We talked about Janelle. Probably won't be here. I don't see Janelle
yet.
I mean, you know, could be a last minute show up. Kim Possible, 731, 978, Beta Blocka, 1111, Law and Disorder, and 1837, The Tartlet Dodger. So your New Hampshire Roller Derby All-Stars will be in the white and pink tonight.
Yes, white and pink. White and pink. We don't have to say radio white.
No, we actually...
They can actually see it.
Yeah.
Whoops. I'm throwing my microphone all over the place.
That's all right.
And
so we've got
storm.
The perfect storm. You can introduce the perfect storm.
Okay. Number 3, Vengeful Vegan. Number 6, Rapunzel. Number 11, Laser Wolf. Number 12, Head of Flame. 17 is Crane Rex. 23, Chain Links. 31, Scarina. 49, Awesome Pants. 81, Princess Layerout. 97, Smacks on Deck. 112 is Shell Bomb. 203 is Oxidizer. Ooh, I said it at the same time they did. 305 is Grim Demise. 828, Kissy Kicks. 925 is Crazy Ness. And that is your perfect storm team.
So I'm I'm watching the Zamboni door go up and down.
I wondered what you were looking at. I thought you were looking at me like I was doing something incorrect.
No, I'm watching the Zamboni door go up and down out there. I don't know if they're... we'll find out. If all of a sudden we go dark, that's because the Zamboni
door just cleaved a very expensive cable in half. Right now, it looks really good.
Luckily, we're all set. I think that's going to work just fine. And the Zamboni door
is going up and down.
Yeah, I feel like somebody must be playing with it. I see the door like going up and down, but I can't see the control panel.
No, so we don't know anybody's doing it.
Who cares about that? Oh, other than it just makes me incredibly nervous. So the Rock Coast Rollers, they're finishing up their announcements right now. I feel really good about this Rock Coast Rollers team. This could be a really big season for them.
It is. It looks really good. In their warm-ups earlier when we were setting up, they looked pretty solid, pretty fantastic.
I didn't even really get a chance.
You didn't?
No, I didn't get a chance to really look and see what was going on. But
I'm still on this screen here.
I can tell them. That's okay.
Sorry.
We're going to start things out today. We have not had a chance to see Grim skating for the Perfect Storm. We've seen Grim Demise a lot.
We have.
Most recently, typically with Casco Bay.
With Casco Bay, yeah. I mean, we've seen her skate with other teams as well, but now
Grim Demise, and she'll be going alongside Knockahoe Down, number 3. Knockahoe Down gets shoved to the outside, but she wasn't trying to go there. Grim Demise is our lead jammer. Knockahoe Down is through. Grim, very fast-moving jammer. The pack speeding up. We've got a goat back there. Looks like Lynx and the Laser Wolf doing a really good job holding back Emily Deckerson. I don't know if they had the full number needed to create the pack, but they definitely...
No, Vengeful Vegan came out on a penalty, so it was just the three of them.
I don't know if they were the largest group out there of both skaters. So Grimm has gone through. She's winding her way through now. She's going to call it. Knock a hoedown about 10 feet from being able to score any points. Grimm, ultra track aware of what's going on.
That is very distracting.
Yeah, I don't know if I like it.
I'd have to move it down here where there's nobody.
Do something different with it.
Yeah.
Over to the upper left-hand corner.
Right, yeah.
That would be even weirder to see it over there.
So you have Rapunzel number 6 for the perfect storm.
In Law and Disorder.
Yeah, I almost just said Law and Order.
Rapunzel hunches down like she's coming off the starting line, and she is on the inside. There was tons of room. She took care of that. Rapunzel is our lead jammer. Law and Disorder tangled up at the back of the pack. She's trying to get by Hedda Flame right now. Hedda has shoved her out and is now going to recycle her back to the pivot line. Meanwhile, over on turn 2 is Rapunzel muscling her way through. She's got 3 blockers immediately to deal with.
Oxidizer coming in to help break that up.
New Hampshire doing a good job here to slow down after Rapunzel having initially blistered her way through. She's only now just coming through with her 5 points. The 5 points she has earned. We'll get a scoring update here. I don't know that New Hampshire has 4 points. I think those are...
We're on a power jam. Lawn Disorder has just gone to the box with a forearm penalty.
So, 30 seconds will be in the favor of Rock Coast, already picking up 5 points for Rapunzel. We'll see if they choose to leave her in the box. I almost think that they might after Rapunzel picks up another 5. She's not yet standing. Although we may see him try to play a long game. And Beard is asking for her to call it. She does. So they want to see her come out there and jam again as they're going to put Kissy Kicks out there for the power start. Kissy with Craziness. Chain Links smacks on deck to block for her. In the penalty box, we have...
Is Vegan still in the box?
I think Vegan is in the box over there.
Yeah, I saw her go over again.
3 blockers for New Hampshire. Kissy Kicks on the outside of turn 1. Almost got taken out. She stayed on the right side of the tape. Muscles her way past 2 blockers. Able to get by Kim Possible. Doot-doot-doot-doot. As well as Tartlett Dodger. She's our lead jammer. So Lawn Disorder pushed out, able to come right back in though. Chain Links goes off. Testosterone Jeremy eyed a penalty and called it. She was already, I actually don't think when Links was called on that, I don't think she was actually past the point of no return, yet she did take the initial lap. She may have been instructed to do so, but
I was going to say she might have been told to do.
I feel like she probably didn't have to. Grim Demise and Punky. Can't say that I don't know what kind of a jammer Punky is. Unless she's had a different name at some point. Then that could be possible.
Well, she's that kind.
She's that kind of jammer. The kind of jammer that gets lead jammer leaves Grimm in the dust. But Grimm is very quick and will close that gap. So Punky will have a chance at some points, but not many. Right now, she'll have at least 1 point she can get. She'll pull it off. She's going to take 1 point from Oxidizer and call it.
2.
She may have got 2 points. She did. And I guess New Hampshire did pick up 4 points early on. I didn't think that they had picked up any points, but they did. So it is now 6 New Hampshire, 26 Rock Coast, Perfect Storm.
I see Loco jamming. I mean,
Rapunzel.
Blocking.
Oh, Mo Loco.
I was trying to name blockers. Vendetta for New Hampshire.
New Hampshire lined up on the pivot line. I don't know that that's super advisable in general terms here with Rapunzel, because she was able to really dart off that line.
Gain a little speed.
Gain some speed. It is Knockahoedown, however, who is our lead jammer. Pack speeds up. New Hampshire moving things along quickly. So there's some time here. New Hampshire did a great job. They've made an opportunity here for Knockahoedown. Knockahoedown's going to pull at least 2 points out of that.
Yep, two.
So New Hampshire appearing to have got their skates back under them. Some really smart play by them. Really worked the pack speed very, very well. Gave her that opportunity when she had Rapunzel hot on her heels.
I've been reading a lot of conversations about starting pivot line, starting jam line, and where packs begin.
Yeah.
And where jammers begin. And so I'm just very interested in watching.
Yeah, see
strategically,
who does what.
Where do these guys decide where they want to be, where they want to start?
Kissy Kicks has the star for The Perfect Storm. And she is
Angelina Jolifo.
Up against Angelina Jolifo. So New Hampshire playing with a little bit deeper jammer rotation. Angelina Jolifo is our lead jammer. Kissy Kicks not quite through yet. She's got three blockers here to tangle with. Now one, she's through. Just as she gets through the pack, here's Angelina. Drives her way in for 3 points, and she'll call it.
And you keep saying this is the year of the pivot start.
It is the year of the pivot start.
It seems to be a trend we've been seeing in previous games this year.
Punky against Grim Demise last jam. We saw Punky with a nice start. Yep. Took Grim off the line and came through for 2 points. We'll see if she's able to repeat for that. Both teams are at full strength. Nope, there'll be no repeating there. On the outside, her skates, I think she has small jets on them. Grim Demise took off. Unimpeded on the outside line. Still trying to get through the pack. Really fast moving pack tonight. So Grim has picked off one, maybe now 2 points. And one whole lap around, and only now just becoming clear of the pack is Punky. So it is a race with Punky and Grim. Grim sends Punky off of turn two and skates on. She now has a little bit of time. Punky will have just picked up a few points. She's already gone through on her initial pass. So Grim has five. Punky really tied up in the pack, unable to move through. And we're going to have a penalty. Is it called on Grim? No, it's not. Grim waits on turn one to see what's going to happen. That was actually just the initial pass for Punky. So Punky, when she got pushed out, I thought she had made her initial pass, but she only just now
she
did.
I think that was about three laps. She got pushed out, and she was behind the pack. She got enveloped with them again. I don't know how that works.
Yeah, I'm trying to think back on that. If they actually...
I can't instant replay it.
That was too long ago.
Yeah.
That's okay. We got a fresh jam. It's going to start right now. Jam number 7 of the day.
Ooh.
Rapunzel.
With 20 minutes and 37 seconds left in this first half.
Knockahoedown and Rapunzel. Almost thought that Knockahoedown found room on the inside, but she did not. Head of Flame was there along with Oxidizer. Closed it down. Rapunzel is our lead jammer. Tonight is a sanctioned game.
Yes, it is.
And a cutting call on Knockahoedown.
That means a power jam for Perfect Storm. Let's see if New Hampshire can burn it.
On the inside, Rapunzel's through. She's picked up five. Head of Flame picked up a penalty as well. She's going to go. and Ripper calls it off. So they're going to go for the power start again, and they're going to give the power start to Kissy Kicks, just as they did last time around. New Hampshire sending up Beta Blocker, Irate Pirate Murphy, and Jinx to block. Yeah, they all call her Ripper. Yeah. You're looking at me like I'm stupid for saying Ripper.
I didn't say it out loud.
No, you wrote it on my notepad, though.
Hey, I was just questioning.
Let's talk Derby. Kissy Kicks. She's through. She's our lead jammer. Standing in the box and now coming back out is number three, knock a hole down. So Kissy Kicks working her way around turn three and four. She tangles up with Jinx.
And
I'm sorry, not
down.
Jinx, Amanda Goodell. I keep calling Amanda Goodell Jinx because of the number two. I saw a late high block called by Testosterone Jeremy. And Coach Beard, he's going to get some clarification. Perhaps on that. We'll see who that was called on. Grim Demise and Law and Disorder will be our jammers. Anyone in the box? It looks like we do have one in the box.
I got a lot of signaling going on here from the refs in the center.
A lot of signaling going on. Whistle blows. Law and Disorder tries to go straight up the middle. No room there. Almost thought Grim was going to get a back block there, but the falling was not initiated by her movement. So Grim, lead jammer, Law and Disorder, clear of the pack. Princess Leia out had to slow down and give her the space. So Grim with, I don't know, eighth of a track length. She'll pick up 1 or 2 points now. She's going to pass through, skating backwards. What's she going to get, 2 points? Probably. Looks like two being held up.
The strategy tonight seems to be pack skate fast.
Very quick moving pack tonight. And both teams really kind of initiating that.
They are, because I was watching, and I've been watching, and it's not just one New Hampshire saying, okay, yeah, keep it moving. Or
yeah, it's really heads-up play on both teams,
yeah,
to know.
Yeah, Storm's not just saying, okay, keep it moving. They're yeah, both saying, let's move.
And they're moving at the opportune times, too. Great track awareness from both teams yeah, tonight. Yeah. Whistle blows. Head of Flame has a star for the first time today. She gets shoved out front. She's going to get recycled back. Almost think she's going to pick up a back block for hitting Vendetta. No, she's not. In fact, she's going to get lead jammer, according to Wifo. And now breaking free of the pack is number 85, Punky for New Hampshire. Head of Flame weaves her way through. A skate came out towards her from 91, Bo Loco, but not enough. 4 points for Rock Coast 50, Rock Coast 12, New Hampshire.
And we're going to be having a timeout.
Timeout. An official timeout.
An official timeout.
Well, let's go right to Little Red Schoolhouse.
Little Red Schoolhouse.
A new sponsor to our show this year is the Little Red Schoolhouse. They're a daycare that offer caring and friendly staff with early childhood education backgrounds and up-to-date training in CPR and first aid. The daycare is located at the Old Warren Elementary School on Main Street in Westbrook. This historic school building has offered them room to grow, a more structured atmosphere, and a convenient location without losing the nurturing aspect of the home daycare. Check them out, the-little-red-school-house.com or call 207-854-0007. Thanks to the Little Red Schoolhouse for supporting us as well as supporting Team Maine Roller Derby with
yes,
your
greatly appreciated
sponsorship. So our signal is still in and out.
Yeah. It's really, really good, and then it goes away.
Yeah. We'll see what happens with that.
So, upcoming dates and things that are happening. We're actually here today.
What? We're here today.
Little tidbit of information. Turn 2 Skate Shop will be here tomorrow at Midcoast Rec Center from 9:45 a.m. to 11:45. She's brought a lot of stuff with her.
Yeah.
So if you're looking for gear or skates and you're in the area, feel free to come up.
I saw some kids over at her table earlier today. And I don't know if they were looking for skates or not, but they were over there.
But yeah, so she'll be there, just throwing that out there. April 23rd, which is next weekend, next Saturday, we will be in Bangor at the Ski Hand Center, Bangor Roller Derby versus the Capital City Rollers, the Daisy Cutters and the Bazooka Janes. The 30th will be Maine Roller Derby's Port Authorities versus Quebec's Les Duchesses.
Les Duchesses, I love them.
And then the May 8th through 9th, we're at Coastal Chaos.
What?
I know.
It never ends. It never ends. Kissy Kicks with the star for The Perfect Storm. We've got Angelina Jo Lethal for New Hampshire. Kissy Kicks wide open on the outside. There was nobody there. The pack had really congealed towards the inside. Gave Kissy plenty of room. Angelina Jo Lethal still tied up. Shoved off onto the inside by Crazy Ness. Recycled back just a little bit. Kissy's through. There's 5 points.
A little dodge and weave there she had.
Kissy will come around again on the inside. Great blocking by Chain Links.
I see.
Made some room for her.
Eventual Vegan is there as well.
Star pass. Irate Pirate, number 10, has the star. Clean star pass by New Hampshire. And Kissy's picked up 4. She'll call it off. No chance for Irate. Rock Coast now leading 64 to New Hampshire's 12. With 15 minutes left in this first half.
That is correct. One of the cool things here with Rock Coast Rollers is they actually have cheerleaders.
I love the cheerleaders.
I do. They're off to our left, off camera. You can't quite see them even on my other view. They're just off to the side.
Ah, we'll get them.
At some point, they'll come running around and get everybody a wave.
Yeah.
I can't change it now.
No, you can't change it now. You probably can't.
Well, if they're going on a timeout, I could. But if they're starting, I can't.
Right. Knock a hoe down.
Nope, I moved it.
Grim demise.
Now they can see the ceiling.
Yeah, they can. Yeah. Nice work.
You're welcome.
Whistle blows. Grim gets around her own teammates. She's going to try to work that outside. No room there just yet. Knock a hoe down, really fighting to get through, but just making no headway. Grim Demise is through. Substantial lead still. Knock a hoe down now, just clear of the pack. Scarina relenting. There's no bridge there for Scarina. Quick juke, spins around, calls it off. Grim Demise picks up 4.
It was so quick, I almost missed it. Like, I barely switched the camera in time.
Yeah, she moved so fast. I don't even know if the refresh rate of the camera was able to pick that up correctly.
I don't think it was. There's Tugboat tape ninjing.
Tape ninjing. Nice work, Tug.
Yep. Beautiful job.
Rapunzel. Lawn Disorder. Both teams full strength. Rapunzel gets down into her crouching position. Looked like she was going to try to go straight through the middle, but she didn't. Made a nice little deke to the left. She's our lead jammer, but Law and Disorder is with her. We'll see if they tangle. Pack speeds up. And it looks like Vegan kind of lost a skate a little bit there. Is now in the back of the pack, so Rock Coast can only go so far out front.
It's a game of catch-up.
It is a game of catch-up right now. We've gone one whole lap.
Almost two now.
And it'll just be called off. Stalemate.
Nice little warm-up.
Yeah. A nice little all-skate. Kissy Kicks, 8:28. Punky, 85. If you're just tuning in, Rock Coast in the black and turquoise. New Hampshire in the white and pink.
Um,
right off the whistle. Both jammers are out. Lead jammer belongs to New Hampshire, though. Kissy Kicks getting right out there. Punky probably going to have to call it off. We'll see what happens. She went to
and then was told not yet.
They want her to go around.
They want her to keep going, so they're also telling the pack, speed up, speed up.
The inside pack refs are going to get a warm up tonight. Wow. And now it'll get called off.
Laser Wolf was doing an excellent job of bridging in that speeding up. Mm. She was making sure she was right between them.
You can try the cheerleader cam. You can see the cheerleaders way in the back there.
You can see a little sparkle.
See, it's a sparkle. There it is. Yeah.
You can also see our
there's
camera
our cheerleaders.
Right there.
There's one of our cameras.
Yeah, and there's some crowd.
Pretty unimpressive.
Look at that.
Yeah, let's just leave it right there on the crowd. We got a nice crowd camera going. That's great. I like that.
Oops, sorry. Let's get it out of the way
now.
Let's
get it out of the way because we want to talk about Derby 17. Angelina, Joe Lethal, and then Grimm. As we've seen so far tonight, Grimm busting through.
Scarina's coming out on a penalty.
Grimm has only not got lead jam one time in her opportunities thus far. I think she has had at least four so far. Grimm watching Joe Lethal across the track to see what's going to happen.
Yeah, waiting till just before she reached the pack to call it off.
10:43 left in this first half.
So, yes, in your upper right-hand corner, you've got some of the crowd over here. That's to our left.
Yep.
See,
I give you an idea.
There's our camera right there.
It's kind of boring.
Whoops, it is boring.
That's the first time we've ever had a moving camera on our show.
And I've been able to move it, too. It's like very professional.
we'll have to hook it up to something motorized, I guess.
Yeah.
Rapunzel, lead jammer.
Nakahodown has the star for New Hampshire. And she's through.
So Nakahodown's clear.
Irate Pirate with
Rapunzel.
A nice knockout.
There's room
Rapunzel.
On the inside, as there's only two New Hampshire blockers right now. We have Amanda Goodell on the bench, and Murphy was only just coming onto the track. A pretty easy 4 points for the Rock Coast Rulers.
And
timeout called by New Hampshire.
Do you want to do one of these?
No.
Okay.
EL Design and Imaging.
Oh.
EL Design, visit EL Design for your custom decals, signs, wearables, and more. Use a long-lasting, durable, and weather-resistant vinyl. Whether it's signs for your business, team, or organization, or custom lettering on your vehicles, they can do it all. Find them on Facebook and on the web, eldesignandimaging.com. We need to have him do some stuff for us.
He's doing stuff for us right now, and I need to put in another order because Coastal Chaos is coming up.
Ooh, yes.
And
ooh, we got to get that.
We are going to attempt to do the fan favorite mug again this year. It was really awesome last year. We had the logos from the participating teams on it, as well as the logo from the weekend tournament. So it was pretty awesome, and we had people vote for their favorite skater over the whole weekend.
Right.
And then at the end of the weekend, we gave it to that skater.
Correct. And last year, Chain Links
walked away with it. Yep.
Did. Skated away with it, actually.
Skated away with it. That's right.
Kissy Kicks and Punky on the line. New Hampshire, three blockers. Number two, Amanda Goodell. But we still have Bo Loco, Kim Possible, and Vendetta on the line for New Hampshire. Kissy Kicks. There was almost room there, but all of a sudden, boy, that got closed off by Bo Loco. No one clear yet now. I hear a whistle. We've got someone. Kissy Kicks. Kissy is our lead jammer. Couldn't quite stay on the line. Punky works to the inside. Kissy really threw herself at that That juke threw herself right off the track, but the timing wasn't too bad. It didn't really impact her as much. She was already behind everyone. She was able to scramble back in quickly. Punky, she's been clear for a while now. She'll meet up with the pack. Nah, she'll meet up with the pack too late. No points for Punky. Kissy will pick up three. 79 Rock Coast, 12 New Hampshire. If you are watching, I would love to know how things look. We actually can't really check to see how things look. So if you're watching, shoot us a message.
Currently, my phone is showing no service.
Oh, no. Occasionally, I'm getting messages in, but...
New Hampshire Law and Disorder has the star. And Grim Demise. Law has the lead jam.
She does. Wow, that's... So Grim.
Over Grim, yep.
I think... Did Law and Disorder get the...
No, it was Punky last time.
Punky. All right.
Fast moving pack, got that one.
That was quick.
Yep. She grabbed her couple of points and called it. Looks like Head of Flame is taking the star this time. As well as Angelina Jo Lethal for New Hampshire.
Yeah. Bounty, you're watching. Let me know how it looks. Is it getting choppy or does it buffer? Tell me what's happening. What's going on here on the track? Sorry.
Head of Flame is... Oh, there she is.
Scrambling.
She was almost through.
She bounced through. She looked like a rag doll coming out of turn two. She's got her composure now.
Angelina Jo Lethal.
New Hampshire not really looking behind them to see where she was at all. And she was able to come through. There was plenty of room on the inside. Tartlett Dodger was there, but I don't know that she knew that's exactly where Hedda was at. Look, they might have been focused a little bit too much on trying to get their own jammer through.
Yeah.
There's a penalty for chain links.
Hedda taking her points and calling it.
6:15 in the first half. This is moving quick.
It is, really.
Rock Coast 88, New Hampshire 14. Kissy kicks and knock a hoe down.
And it's still a very fast-moving game. I mean, this pack speeds right up very quickly.
Now, if you don't watch Derby very often, if you're just tuning in today, and you look at a point differential like 88 to 14, and you say, wow, that's kind of a big difference. It is a big difference. However, this is how teams get from good to great.
That's right.
Team like New Hampshire will play against a very well-balanced, very strong team like Rock Coast, and New Hampshire's going to come out of this with an incredible amount of experience and furthering their own ability. There's 4 points picked up by New Hampshire, knock a hoedown. We see that all the time. We've seen that with teams like Bangor, who spent a good part of the season before this.
Yeah, last season. Playing
some really difficult teams
Canadian.
Lumber Smacks, Lay the Sheds, teams they probably didn't have a great chance of beating, but boy, they came out of there with a ton of experience. And you know that's what's going to happen with New Hampshire today.
Yep.
For the first time today, New Hampshire now back-to-back lead jam. This time around, it's Law and Disorder beating Grim Demise off the line for the second time they've gone head-to-head.
And it may seem like a huge lead, but at the same time, we can come back to the second half and they can close that lead.
They can close the lead.
Really quickly, and next thing you know, it'll only be a 10 or 20-point game, and that's a jam.
So Rock Coast, I think we're going to see no points here for New Hampshire, but Rock Coast really did a great job of staying ahead of New Hampshire. The pack speed was set. And it was not in the advantage of New Hampshire to try to score points in that case, as it was actually easier for Grimm to score points. She was closer to eligible blockers than New Hampshire was at the time. So good call off. Punky and Head of Flame. Head of Flame with a little shoulder action off the start. And Punky said no thanks and stepped out of the way. Punky, our lead jammer. So this is three jams in a row now that New Hampshire has come out in the lead. We are getting closer to summer because I can see that Head of Flame has a sunburn. You can see, man. It's almost the same color as the pink on New Hampshire's jerseys. Knock a hoe down, kissy kicks. And look at that pivot start up there.
Yeah. Hey, that's what we've been talking about.
2016 year, the pivot start.
Yep. We're seeing it.
The pivot line, the pivot start. Ooh, and a crash. Awesome pants. Awesome pants was on the ground. Knock a hoe down. She going to make this four in a row for New Hampshire? Kissy Kicks has two to get by. The knock a hoe down does. Four jams in a row New Hampshire has owned. And Kissy was almost out of the pack, but she's been re-enveloped.
Knock a hoe down's told, keep going, keep going.
So knock a hoe down gets pushed off to the infield. Issue. Are we going to pick up a track cut? We did not. I thought, boy, it was really close. I thought knock a hoe down. I thought she had picked up a track cut, but she did not.
Actually, she did get called out. She's got to go to the long way
around. Okay. So she was called out on the penalty,
she
but
went to
missed
come,
it.
She went to come out off the track, and she turned around to come
she
back.
Had, right,
and they,
she had already passed it.
Yeah, she had already passed, yeah.
So we're going to have a do-si-do in the jammer box. And just like that, we'll go the full 2 minutes, 49 seconds left.
That was a little bit of confusion.
It was a lot of confusion. I feel like we stayed pretty tight with it, though. That was good. We didn't get too lost.
Yeah, yeah.
I thought we had seen the track cut on the inside. Yeah. Awesome Pants had laid a pretty significant check. And knock a hoe down went to the infield. Ever so briefly, Kissy Kicks is through. She's picked up 4 points. Knock a hoe down, holding her side.
Yeah, she had a pretty hard hit.
She's going to get by Rapunzel. Bo Loco with a big shoulder into Kissy Kicks. That was kind of a...
So you just took that one and erased the other one I did, right?
Oh, probably, yeah. I didn't know. I'll leave that alone. Let's take a look just out of curiosity here. So we'll see New Hampshire. Forms up. Here comes Kissy Kicks. She tries to go through and to split the defense, and Bo says no. We'll watch that one more time on the Devastation instant replay.
Boom.
Boom. No room.
See, the one I had captured over here was when they knocked their jammer to the ground.
Only
and she
question,
bounced
though,
off.
Is... Yeah, so you'll see her feet never leave the ground. You'll watch.
No, but you see, it'll come over
if
again.
If you watch, Bo.
Right here, watch this. Boom.
Yeah, I know, but what I'm, my concern was, is it a counterclockwise initiation?
Wait. Okay.
But I think what you're going to find is, I mean, if you look at Bo's feet, they never really, I don't think they go in the opposite direction enough. It looks like she just kind of plants herself over her left skate to prepare for the initiation.
I guess that probably was a better instant replay than the one I grabbed.
Gave us something to talk about for that entire time
out.
Well,
I know, but I got the New Hampshire jammer. See how she's...
Oh.
I got her when she fell over there, when she got pushed down and bounced, literally bounced. That's what I took.
Oh, yeah. That was probably a good one, too. Although it still exists. It's just not the one that's
queued up now. It's just not
now.
The last one.
Yeah, right.
I'd have to go find it, and I don't know how to do that.
That's a lot of work.
And then I'd lose where I was in the game and not know what camera I'm on.
Yeah, we just don't know. Punky.
I don't want that to happen.
Grim
it
demise.
On its own.
Grim spins around. She's through. She's our lead jammer. Probably some of the best footwork I've seen comes from Grim Demise. Also a very good TED Talk.
Yes.
You go online. She's got a great TED Talk. You just picked up. You did. I was going to say, did you grab it? You did.
I did.
Punky trying to make her way through. Chain links all up in her business. Along with Scarina. Scarina. I'm sorry, not Scarina. It's Vengeful Vegan. Scarina, though, I've noticed today not jamming.
No, she's been blocking.
She's been blocking. I think that's a good move.
Yeah.
She does have the pivot cover, though, should they need to transfer that over.
Whoops, sorry. Oh, totally missed it.
Moving around Loco. Calling
totally
it off.
Missed that one. All right, let's see what we got
let's
here.
See what you have here. What are we looking for here? We're going to watch Grimm.
Oh,
on the outside.
It was close.
Yeah.
Kind of have a little refs in the way.
Some. We're going to go to halftime now.
That sounds like a plan.
So let's try to make this.
Halftime.
Let's try to make this halftime thing happen here.
Okay.
That's weird. What do we got going on there? I got to just do this and this. And here. Let's see if Siege of New York is going on. Can we listen to Siege of New York? They are currently broadcasting. So here we are, Siege of New York.
Wild.
Enjoy.
It was a hard-fought battle. As we mentioned earlier, both teams probably pretty tired from their earlier games today. And they were true competitors out there, giving it all out on the track. Strong Island now going for their lap, high-fiving the crowd, and low-fiving as well.
Sometimes you gotta change it up now and again. But thanks a lot, everybody. I'm Bulldozer. This was great. I appreciate having the pleasure to announce for you.
That's right, and I'm Verbal Tease. Hit me up on Facebook. We'll be talking again sometime tomorrow. We've got more Derby action here live, so if you can make your way to John F. Kennedy Arena, come on down and see some roller derby live and in person.
We got two more games tonight, so stay tuned. We'll be passing it off to a couple friends of ours. Hello to Sarcasm and our good friend Tom. Going to be kicking it off in just a few minutes. Thanks for listening, everybody.
We're back at the Midcoast Rec Center. I'm Chad. This is Ginny. Hi, Ginny.
I don't have my headphones set yet.
Oh, she doesn't have her headphones on. Rock Coast Rollers lead 112 over New Hampshire Roller Derby to 26.
I've been playing with the camera.
Ginny's been playing with the camera. And I don't blame you.
It's kind of fun.
Yeah, it is a lot of fun.
You never know what you might get.
We're ready to get back underway. Grim Demise has a star for Rock Coast. Knock a Hoe Down has a star for New Hampshire. Both teams are at full strength. Perfect Storm will send Scarina, Laser Wolf, Vengeful Vegan, and Chain Lynx to go alongside Emily Deckerson. Let's see, who else have we got over there? I can't tell because I got everybody else in the way.
Jeff always asks the question.
I should stand up.
When we come back from halftime, what was the conversation in the locker room? He always asks that when we're broadcasting.
So
what do you think?
So I think for New Hampshire, I say, all right, we found some things that worked at the end of that.
Definitely
the
did.
First half.
Don't lose that momentum.
Yeah, don't lose that momentum. Let's continue to see what we can do with that and see what we can do to chip away at this lead. I think with Rock Coast, they know what they have. They know what their game plan is. They're not going to change anything. There's not such a lead that they have that they would say, hey, let's just play around with some weird change-ups or whatever. This is not a game to do that. This is a sanctioned game. So the score differential for a sanctioned game matters for the WFTDA points. So they are still going to come out here and pile on the points if they can.
Yep.
New Hampshire, you can come out and you look and go, yeah, well, they don't stand a chance. They're not going to come back and win. Okay, maybe they don't. However, that also makes a difference in their standings as well. How well do they perform against a team that statistically would be a better team than them?
It makes a difference. If they can close that gap,
it makes a difference.
It makes a huge difference in their standings. I agree. I think the speeding up the pack and keeping that pack moving has benefited both teams very, very much.
It has. And I think, New Hampshire has done some things today that just the second half of the first half really worked well for them. Mm-hmm. I don't know if it was maybe their positioning on their starts, but they were able to get the lead jammer position at least four, maybe five times in a row. This time around, lead jammer belongs to Grim Demise. But Grim will start off our second half, tied up in the pack, almost through is Knock a Hoe Down. And Knock a Hoe Down is through, having got just past Vengeful Vegan. Quick jump.
I tried to grab it. I don't know if I got it.
4 points for Rock Coast.
Let's see if I got her. Sometimes people are positioned just so that I can't get her.
Right.
Get the jump.
Zoop.
Jumped right around her.
You can see her feet in there.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the important part.
Rapunzel in Lawn Disorder.
Oh,
we got a timeout called.
So.
Why? What are we going to talk about? Ooh, Duct Tape Company.
Yeah.
Special thanks to the Duct Tape Company. If you have ever seen our broadcast setup. Wait, you know what I was just thinking? Don't do the tape rip on mic anymore.
Why?
We don't have that much tape left.
That's a really good point.
Yeah, so we might not want to be ripping 12 feet of tape off for the sound effect. Special thanks to the Duct Tape Company.
I don't even have any old tape to rip.
If you've seen our broadcast setup, you know it's a mess. We use Duct Tape's Clean Release Blue Painter's Tape at every bout to help us keep our cables on the tables. We use it because it pulls off cleanly, unless you leave it on there too long, and then there is a residue. There's nothing worse than sticky residue on your gear. True. If we didn't have duct tape, we couldn't keep the show together. Visit duckbrand.com.
So what we need to do is we need to record that tape ripping sound and then just play it.
And then just play it off a soundboard
like
or something.
Audio. Yeah.
Yeah, that would make a lot more sense.
It would. But you're right. We are almost out of... Well, we say almost out, but we are almost out. We had a nice sized box full of tape. And
yep. I'll have to put in a new request.
We've got several rolls left. We use it. lot.
I went out and made a few changes on our antenna array at halftime.
We got to name it.
Charlie.
Are you naming it Charlie?
Yeah.
Why?
I don't know. I just like the name Charlie. I don't know. It's just the first thing that came to my mind.
Whoa, okay, Derby.
We got Derby
again.
Going on out here.
Chad,
Rapunzel.
This is a family-friendly show.
I'm sorry. I forgot. Well, my family doesn't care. Well, they might. Rapunzel, lead jammer. And there was lots of room for her. She's running into, crashing into, one last blocker. Nice work by 731 Kim Possible to hold her back.
We need that on a button too.
So far I've managed to do that every single time.
You have. You've done really well. I'm sure she'll appreciate it.
Or think it's creepy. Like, why is that guy watching Kim Possible?
Well, I haven't actually watched Kim Possible in years.
I know.
Like, ever.
All that conversation we were just having. Rapunzel netted herself a grand slam.
And there was an attempted star pass to Loco. She has
a star
in her hand. She's
going to go through for another one. That's two grand slams in a row. Rapunzel stacking the nickels.
As Loco, it still has the star in her hand, and she's just desperately
trying to get rid of it.
She keeps
and another five.
Out.
That's 15 right
well,
there.
And now Loco's heading to the box.
So there's 30 seconds left in the jam. So she's got 15 points now. She's going to call it after having another 5 points. She'd gone through one more time. She had five unanswered points.
I didn't switch the cameras because I was watching what was in front of me.
Oh, for crying out loud, Jenny. This is why we can't take you places. See, every time I see our data dropping, I look out the door to see if the wind is picking up, but there's going to be a delay in that, so I don't know. I need to stop worrying about the technical things. So from our vantage point, you can see the white in the background.
Behind the cheerleaders.
That's the Zamboni door. Right now, the Zamboni is not there because it's over in the next bay over, which is the garage maintenance bay. I know because I was snooping around in there earlier.
I opened
a door. I turned a light on. And
there it was.
Bam.
Glowing.
Glowing. I had everything I could do to hold back the 12-year-old child in me to not go and get on the Zamboni. Like,
it was pretty cool. But anyway, our antenna is right out those doors, those garage bay doors.
And there's a wireless network that we have set up in between here and over there. You can see the cardboard cutout of a cheerleader just behind that. You probably can't see that on your screen at all, Mike.
Yeah, it's really small.
But anywho.
And kind of is lit out.
We have a power start for Kissy Kicks. Kissy Kicks is probably pretty grateful to her for her team today because this is at least the third power start they have provided for her. Yeah. And she's got the advantage of only three blockers. Smacks tried to make some room by shoving a few people over there, but we saw a penalty get picked up there. Crazy Ness picked up a penalty. But lead jammer belongs to Kissy. We got Flash Drive telling them where the pack is. Kissy's through. She's picked up five. And Law and Disorder has made her initial pass through. Kissy with lots of time on her hands. Works to the outside, runs into Loco. Loco got pushed off the track, so that gave just enough room for Kissy Kicks to get past her. She's working with 4 points right now. She's going to keep going. And great call to have her keep going. Lawn Disorder pick up a track cut. So 58 seconds left in this jam. 30 seconds of that, unless a penalty is picked up by Kissy Kicks, will be a power jam. Rock Coast will slow down as long as they can. No pack is called. Flash Drive now calling a penalty on
Lynx.
That's her third penalty of the day. I can see the penalty board from here. No one in Rock Coast is even really in any danger of penalties. I see three penalties at most on Laser Wolf and three penalties for Chain Lynx. I'll take a look here at New Hampshire momentarily.
I was confused with that last start. I must have missed something because I thought it was Loco that had the star. But then it ended up being...
Maybe they did a little switcheroo. You didn't see it.
I think it was something not right because it was an attempted star pass.
So
I'll have to go back and watch it later.
Also, no one in any danger with their penalties. The most, I think, Emerly Deckerson looks like she has three penalties along with Amanda Goodell. Amanda may have three penalties up there. That's what it looks to be. And then the remaining penalties are all kind of spread out with ones and twos. 4 points picked up by Grim Demise. Lawn Disorder still tied up in the pack. She's taking a bruising from Scarina. Scarina not holding back. Grim is going to call it off. Rightly so.
A little chain Lynx dancing on camera there.
Yeah, Lynx dancing. It's not uncommon.
Nope. What's uncommon was the fact that I had that camera on.
Right. Yeah.
Usually I go to the overhead camera and I don't get anybody dancing. All right. So you have Punky with the star for New Hampshire and Rapunzel.
Yes, we do. Off the line. Rapunzel muscles her way through. She's tough. She's a strong one, and she will consistently muscle her way through. And then sometimes she'll surprise you with a little head fake. Didn't have to this time. She came through the front stretch. Nearly got a well-placed hip from Bo Loco, but the timing was in the benefit of Rapunzel.
During halftime, you might have noticed the cheerleaders came out with their hula hoops.
Hula hoops and kids engaging
and kids
the...
And with, yeah. They had panties on there.
This is one of the fuller houses I've seen here for Rock Coast in quite a while.
It's kind of why I panned around with the
camera.
Yeah,
the bleachers are quite filled up.
It was kind of nice to see.
And the suicide seating on turn one and turn two looks good. And, of course... All of our VIP seating here on 3 and 4 is filled up. Plus a lot of folks mingling around. Oh, yeah, there's Derby happening. I'm sorry.
Sorry about that.
There's some great Derby happening here, too, as well. Lawn Disorder fighting with Vegan and Chain Lynx. Almost gets through. Hasn't quite yet. Still not through. No lead jammer yet. We've made one. Oh, we do have a lead jammer. Lead jammer belongs to Kissy Kicks.
Yep.
She picks up four. I didn't think we had a lead jammer.
Kind of came late to the jam.
Yeah, well, I did. I came late to the jam. I was too busy yammering my mouth off about the fans and how great they look tonight.
Fans are important.
Love them. Every one of them. Well, except a couple, but that's neither here nor there. Beta blocker with a big shoulder onto Kissy Kicks. Just looking over here at our camera angle. That looks pretty good. Star pass with the star now is
Irate Pirate.
Captain Irate. Captain Irate Pirate.
Arr.
Probably Irate because people keep doing that. 173 Rock Coast, New Hampshire 26. I see some skaters coming in to start warming up. I don't know who they are, though. I think they are Cherry Bombs.
Yeah. That's next. This is a doubleheader.
It is a doubleheader. We get Woo-hoo! To do this again.
I love doubleheaders.
I am excited about that. I think we've got some of our technical stuff figured out.
Hope so.
I think
Grim
we have because I haven't been thinking about it much.
Grim. Lead, but Punky is not far behind
right
her.
Right there. So we'll watch This pack will speed up. We've got two hanging behind. That'll be Grimm's first point. Will be 203 Vendetta. That may be the only point she gets.
That was kind of a twist and a spin, and she lost.
She did lose a skate, so 1 point for the Perfect Storm.
So there's a lot of people around us.
Yeah.
Behind us. Can't quite get all the way around. Oh.
Good view of the Midcoast Rec Center here.
Yeah.
Getting a tour. Some skybox seating up there.
Yep. Oh, well, sorry. Shaky
really
camera.
Not really skybox seating. Rapunzel moves left, right, trying to find an opening here. New Hampshire putting together a brick wall. Well, that brick wall just collapsed in a heap. Still, though, no one's through yet. Both teams are a little spread out. Rapunzel stays in the right place. Irate Pirate almost had her to the inside. Almost doesn't count. Rapunzel, lead jammer, coming through on her first scoring opportunity. She's going to pick up a couple. No, she's not going to pick up any. No points either team.
Okay, so here's the other side of us. Oh, there's Chad's head.
Oh, wee.
And you can see the fans.
Yeah, there it is. Oh, that's a good shot. I like that shot right there. Keep that.
Too.
Keep that. Supple.
Well, I was going to show the people that are on the other side, but.
We'll build something. I'll come
All
up
right.
with something.
Derby. Derby.
Derby's happening. Knock a hoe down. Kissy Kicks. And it is Kissy Kicks, who was our lead jammer. Easily through. Skated it around smoothly. Now she will meet up with the pack.
A little bouncing around.
New Hampshire spread out quite a bit. Big block by Amanda Goodell. Kissy, it does not look like she's picked up any points just yet. Now she will. She'll pick up her four and she'll call it.
Just before Nakaho down.
Those were not easy points. ...18-10 left in the game. 179 Rock Coast, 27 New Hampshire. Punky with the star alongside Grimm. We've got blocking. We've got Oxidizer. Shell Bomb is up there. Awesome Pants and Scarina for Perfect Storm. New Hampshire. We'll talk about New Hampshire's block here in a second. Jammer on jammer, coming out on turn three and turn four. Tartlet Dodger, Bo Loco, Kim Possible, doot, 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 doot.
Every time.
And 203, Vendetta.
She calls it.
Called off. Punky takes a spill, goes over, says hi to the Rock Coast bench.
I missed that. If I had had that camera, it would have been, I would have got it.
You'd had that up there.
Would have got it. Yeah.
Why?
It's kind of a weird angle. I got the cameras in there. I have no idea.
Why did we just turn down east for a minute?
Because that was what you, that's the way you said it.
I started, I guess. Lawn Disorder, Rapunzel.
My fault.
Whistle blows.
I exaggerated it.
Lawn Disorder, thought she could work right. Not quite. She'll get recycled back by Head of Flame. Rapunzel is our lead jammer. Lawn Disorder again, pushed off to the inside. Head of Flame tries to recycle her back as far as possible, but Head of takes a spill. And again, Lawn Disorder will be recycled back. Meanwhile, around the corner, Rapunzel comes through. She's picked up 5 points. 1 thing I'm not seeing a lot of in the last few jams is any geometric blocking. I'm not seeing any diamonds,
triangles,
triangles,
squares.
Not seeing that.
Diamonds.
You watch. They'll Lucky do it. Charms. They'll do it over the next 10 jams.
Yeah.
Maybe not. Hey, there's boat.
There is.
The tape is under the watchful eye. Of
and it really boat. Looks fantastic.
It looks good.
It does.
Good high contrast. Yeah.
And he's using a zebra water gun. Not only that,
he's
going to
stand right in front of me.
He's also plugged his phone into our chart, into our.
Oh, nice. Kissy Kicks, she's our lead jammer.
So I said, go ahead.
Knock a hoedown. Now just coming through the pack, Kicks with lots of time. Half track length lead right now, and the pack speeding up. Knock a hoedown has not really even closed that gap at all. Knock a hoedown has had the same half track distance for two laps. Do I have a plug? I can plug my phone in to charge it.
If you had a brick, what you plug it in up here?
Do. No, I don't even have a cord.
I do.
What
do you
no.
need your phone for? You can't even do
no,
anything.
No, you're
on
right.
It.
I can't. Difference is in there. How do I care? It's
mine still says no service, so whoops, sorry.
You should change the camera here.
Well, you distracted
me. I'm sorry. I probably did do that.
All right. Grim Demise.
Grim Demise.
Angelina Joe Lethal with the star. I saw the hand go up like she was going to pass it, but.
There was a time we were going to try to, I wanted to set up a radar on our desk. I wanted to know how fast the pack was moving.
Yeah.
Or how fast jammers were moving. Grim Demise and a rare penalty. Track cut. Power jam for New Hampshire. Wifo will be putting her hand up in the air momentarily. Ooh, we may pick up a back block though. We did.
Yep.
Yeah, back block picked up by New Hampshire. I saw the same thing from over here. Angelina Joe Lethal, she'll go to the box. Here comes Grim Demise again. So we'll go the full, we would have anyway, gone the full 2 minutes. We're halfway through the jam. Only 13 minutes left in this first half.
Mm-hmm.
On the outside is Grim. There's five, according to Mr. Fantasy. Jammer standing in the box. Grim is through. Did she pick up a track cut? I think she did.
She did. Mr. Fantasy called her. I wondered about that.
I don't know if we'll be able to get it or not.
I don't know that we will.
We'll find out. We'll see what happens.
Oh, I hear cowbell.
Cowbell. Falling to the inside.
10 seconds left in this jam.
There's five more for New Hampshire.
This was a very good jam for them. They've gained.
And that'll be the end of it. Another three for New Hampshire. We'll look and see if that we happens to grab that. Nope. We only got
one.
She went
yeah.
to the box after acknowledging she had it.
Yeah, that's okay. We tried.
No prob. Punky with the star for New Hampshire. I can't
with
say that I remember seeing Punky before tonight, but I've been rather impressed.
We haven't seen New Hampshire since last summer, I don't believe.
I think that's correct.
I think the last time we saw them, it was at their
It was
JFK
in New Hampshire.
Coliseum.
Yeah, JFK.
Yep.
How are we going to
really
broadcast
hot.
Out of JFK this
oh,
year?
Oh, so hot.
We've done it once from up in the box, once,
and once down on the floor.
Down the floor. Huh. I guess I should focus on this game and not one that is.
Yeah, that doesn't exist for us
doesn't
yet.
Doesn't exist yet. Yeah.
Which is
that.
A good reminder that if there are events that would, like, people would like to have Nerd Derby at, we have a form you can fill out.
We do. It's right on our Facebook page. If you go to the top, posted.
It's pinned to the top.
Pinned.
Pinned. Pinned. That would be the best way. Sending us a message is great, except that...
I lose it.
I might not always see the message because Chad gets it.
I do not respond in time.
And I'm the one that actually fills out the calendar. So filling out the form would be awesome. And then we can make sure that we can broadcast from your facility.
Punky with a power start. Not a very long power start, though. Grim Demise was right off the bench. There's room on the inside. Vendetta tried to push her to the infield, but was not able to. Although Grimm does get shoved to the outside on the backstretch. Neither jammer making any huge headway. Now Grimm will on the outside.
Inches lead.
Bo Loco tried to put the hip in the way, but it wasn't quite enough. Grimm is a jukey little mess of a jammer that is just all over the place.
Is, but she's strong and she knows where she's going. She knows what she's doing. You know what I mean? Like, this is what's happening. This is what I'm doing.
Also, very vocal on the track, too.
Yep.
Communicates very well with the rest of the team. If you were ever going to compare a jammer to a quarterback calling the shots, it's probably Grimm who I see do that the most.
Oops, I'm sorry. That instant replay was not supposed to happen.
Grimm, as well as kind of a microburst, is very similar. But microburst is not in this game.
Nope, she's not.
We'll probably see her next time around, though.
I don't think she's on the next game either.
What?
Nope.
Meh.
Not on this list anymore.
All right. Kissy
kicks.
And jinx.
You owe me Coke. I don't like Coke.
So. I don't either. Lead jammer belongs to none other than Nakaho down. Kissy now just through, just getting past Murphy. So she's got a little bit of time, Nakaho down does. Lynx pushing her teammate. She was shoving smacks. And it worked out quite well. 3 points picked up by New Hampshire. 1 point for Rock Coast.
That camera's really not that exciting over there.
No, it's just not.
Not a whole lot happens.
I thought it would be, but it's not.
Maybe if it was closer.
Did you just instinctively look outside to see if it was windy as well?
No, I was looking to see what the cheerleaders were doing because I was going to move the camera to them. So,
nothing.
Oh, look who has the star. Skyrina for Perfect Storm.
Hey.
But Angelina Jo Lethal, shot out.
Shot out. She's our lead jammer. I don't think that Skyrina has forgotten how to be a jammer.
Oh, goodness, no.
I sometimes wonder, jammers, and I
don't think you can forget. It's like riding a bike. I don't ride a bike very often, but I remember how to do it.
I'm wondering if some of these jammers, like Skyrina, I don't know why I picture this, but I think if you were to kind of like blow a whistle in the grocery store, like she'd take off.
Would you?
No. I'd assume I was being like, I think that was a police officer or something. Well, of course, I'd have to be in England for that. Nobody would hear.
I would
Ripper
probably look
through
and wait to hear somebody holler 5 seconds. Listen for Ermagerd's 5 seconds.
Lawn disorder. Picked up a penalty. So it's a power jam for Rock Coast. Rock Coast sitting quite comfortably at 209 points. New Hampshire 35. And Rapunzel will call it off. And this will be like the sixth power start for Kissy Kicks.
Yeah, she's really doing well with those. What?
Just looking at that corner camera, just looked a little out of focus.
A little fuzzy?
Yeah.
We'll have to fix it.
Meh. I know. I know. We have our whistle. Kissy kicks. Had two to deal with. Now she's through. Carla Dodger spun to the ground. New Hampshire a little split up right now.
Law and disorder now coming back on the track. Ah.
Kissy's through for five. 7 minutes left in this game. A long disorder now clear of the pack on her initial loop around. While Kissy doing her best to disassemble the defense. I hear salt and pepper.
I feel like it's been playing the whole time. I don't know if it has or if it's just been.
Salt and pepper will be performing at the Cross Insurance Center this October.
Why do you know that?
Because somebody was talking about it the other day at work. So I thought I'd just share it.
Are you going?
No, it's a 90s.
It's a 90s tour.
Yeah, I actually think Vanilla Ice is going to.
I did see something.
Yeah. I thought he was building houses or something.
I didn't know if it was real, you know, one of those.
Yeah, maybe they're like tribute bands. It'd be hilarious if people didn't know they were tribute
like
bands.
Like the Journey. Tribute band.
I think there is a Journey tribute band. They're actually called Journey. The joke there being Journey is kind of just a tribute band to their own music. Sorry, Journey fans. Not Go Down calls it. And Grim helps her stay upright. Grim looks like she's having a good time.
Yeah. Big smiles always.
Now we're down to the 5 minute mark. Should have brought our padded seats.
Yeah.
Not so much that these metal chairs are hard, but they're cold.
They are. Which is why I think they were trying to shut the door over there.
Yeah, probably, yeah.
But they probably were afraid of closing it all the way because our cable was there.
Yeah. I could have put a piece of tape over the safety mechanism, and it would never have closed. Maybe that's why it didn't close, is because the wire had popped up in front of the little eye, so it just kept going back up again.
Oh, that's possible. I don't know.
Whoops, sorry. Sorry.
The poor Julie's are freezing to death, and it's all our fault.
That'd be all right. Rapunzel, lead jammer. She's had a great night. Very consistent. Works for the breakaway. Tends to get it. There's five more. It's not really later this month, but it is early next month. We will be here for the Coastal Chaos Tournament. 3 days, starts on a Friday, ends on Sunday.
Yep.
I don't know how many games it is, but I think we'll be able to stream it. I like where we sit.
That's our plan. This was our test. Today, as you said that, it went red. But
yeah,
that
of course.
Our,
but
this was our
again.
Test.
This was the big test for that. So I know what we need to do is tomorrow, Ian and I need to head up to the garage and see what we can build. I also know we don't really have to have that tall of an antenna.
It doesn't have to be that tall?
No. Okay. So I've got a piece of black iron pipe. I don't know how we're going to get it down here. Oh, shit. Sorry, Jody. Sometimes I lose focus. Ooh, track cut. Did Pirate draw the track cut? Yep, she did.
Kissy Kicks is
Kissy
going
kicks.
To the box. That means Punky.
Punky.
Is coming.
Then I
finished
think.
Her penalty.
And Punky may have the opportunity to become lead jammer because I don't know that Kissy did have it.
She is lead jammer. Whoops.
She is lead jammer. Floor's a little slippery around 3 and 4. She's back up, though. She never lost any momentum as she was sliding. She just kind of kept going and got her back up again. Oxidizer, awesome pants.
Oh, she called it, leaving Kissy in the box.
Kissy's in the box.
And a timeout is being called by New Hampshire, I believe.
I don't know if I would have left Kissy out of the box.
Oh, calling offenses, you can see, is using our zebra watering hole.
Shit, that was awesome.
He switched it just as he did it.
Yeah.
Speaking of our zebra watering hole, we'd like to thank EL Design.
Thanks, Everett.
He is made the sign that is our zebra watering hole. Helped us with the idea. We had an idea, and he helped us see that come through. EL Design, you can check them out. They're on Facebook. They're on the web. They can do personalized mugs.
The interweb.
Yep. They can do. He can do steins, badges, license plates, keychains, T-shirt lettering, vehicles, large signs, vans, trucks. I mean, I've seen him do recently. He did a couple of vans.
Yeah.
And he did somebody's truck for their business. The sign out front of their business. Bunch of T-shirts for a construction company.
He's been right out straight.
He has been right out straight.
We better get some get our needs over there.
Yeah, I know. Knock a hoe down with your star for New Hampshire. Kissy Kicks in the box standing. And
now
here
she's
she
out.
Is.
So Kissy shoved off to the infield. Her skates stayed on the right side of the tape, though. So only her elbows went out. I don't know that our halftime broadcast worked.
I don't either, because we kind of.
I kind of forgot that it would also be downloading. See, that's all fuzzy.
Over here.
Everywhere, right here. Fix it.
Well, I can fix it, but I got people skating and I have to switch. And
we need a crew of about four.
We do.
Yeah, we need about two. We need two more people. Well, we need three more people. Would you like to come broadcast with us? You send me a message. I've got room. I got an extra microphone. I need one.
But you have an extra microphone, yeah.
Come broadcast. Come do it. Or start your own broadcast if you want.
We encourage that.
I was super excited. We talked about it earlier today, but. We saw
Nope. Right there.
Yep. So we happened to see two tournaments today broadcasting on Mixlr, our favorite radio streaming partner, Mixlr. Siege of New York, where Providence Roller Derby was playing.
Providence was playing D.C.
Was in playing D.C., yep. And Siege of New York. Garden State from New Jersey was playing down there. We tuned in and listened to them early this morning. Looked like they were getting a fair amount of listeners, too.
Yeah.
That was exciting.
And then the...
We just missed an entire jam because we were talking about this.
Siege of New York.
27 seconds left in the game. What do you think? This our last jam? Yeah.
Yeah.
Probably.
Oh, 23 jams.
23. Let's go 24 jams. Well, 24 this one. An even number. We have our whistle. Oh, there was almost plenty of room, but then it got closed off. Beta blocker was right in the way. Star pass immediately to...
Irate Pirate.
Captain Irate.
Craziness went to the box.
Craziness headed to the box.
Rapunzel
picks up a penalty.
She was...
So we'll end with a power jam. Irate Pirate with the star. Irate Pirate moves through on the inside. Princess Leia out. Was pushed out of the way by Amanda Goodell. So Pirate picks up 5 points. 1:15 left in this jam. It will be our final jam. Princess Princess Leia out in Grim Demise, blocking Irate Pirate.
Oop, Grim Demise is going for the box for that one.
Yep.
She was like, oops, sorry.
Oops, sorry. Didn't mean to. And Pirate was able to keep going, so it wasn't. She was not pushed fully out. Or she was, but it didn't matter because it was a penalty.
Rapunzel is back out on the track.
There's Punzel, Ripper, Rapunzel. They're optional. There's options on that name.
There is.
Rip.
Punzel.
Punzi. Oh, wow. Fantastic block there.
I don't know. Rapunzel hit her head really hard.
We'll take a look at it.
When this is done.
When this is done.
Not right now.
Not right now, yeah. We're going to just cut away. New Hampshire scrappy to the end here. Boloco out with a penalty.
And that
scrappy
is your unofficial end.
Rock Coast 256, New Hampshire 45. We'll take a look at just to see what the that last...
Oh, instant replay, see
yeah,
if we got it.
Yeah, see how that looked. So we'll see
Here
Rapunzel coming around the backstretch. And a really well-timed hip. Trying to see who that was that...
Right there.
Yeah. Yeah, I can't see whose number that is. I'm sure the fans at home know. All right, so.
I think it was Beta Blocker.
Yeah, that might have been Beta. So we are going to.
I got a whole lot of skaters standing behind us.
Yeah, they're all really eager to get out on the track.
It's a little intimidating.
So we'll come back with the MVPs.
Yep.
In the beginning of the next game,
yes,
we'll stop streaming for now just so that we don't we're not using a bunch of bandwidth that we don't have. So we'll be back in probably 15 to 20 minutes. Probably 20 minutes. We'll be back. All right. Thanks for tuning in on game one. We'll be back for game two shortly.